this is Professor Danny Antonio of Hapler. We will now be discussing major issues besetting the real estate sector as it affects our incoming president. Best is to start maybe taking a closer look at what the Aquino administration has achieved in the 6 years that it has been managing the country, particularly those affecting the real estate sector. To his credit, President Aquino has been able to improve the climate for business, particularly the real estate sector. So we noticed that the GNP and GDP has grown substantially, consistently over 6.5-7% the past 6 years. This has improved the credit rating of the country. And with the improved credit rating of the country, private companies such as real estate companies now are also able to source cheaper loans for their particular projects. This has allowed a lot more companies to develop more projects all over the country. And this has been one reason why the real estate sector boomed during the Aquino administration. There also has been plenty of infrastructure projects introduced by the government, some of which had been completed, a lot more which would be completed in the next couple of years. This would be on the road systems, on the elevated highways, and so on. It looks good. There should be more projects like that, but to his credit, at least President Aquino has started the ball rolling. What about the next president? What can he do or what should he do relative to policies that he should set affecting the real estate sector? One of the major shortfalls of the Aquino administration that affected the real estate sector is that certain laws which were already approved or already enacted did not really take off during his administration. One of those would be the Real Estate Investment Trust Law. This particular legislation, which was supposed to put the Philippines at par with all of their, with all our Asian neighbors, did not get implemented because the implementing rules and regulations have not been done. The Department of Finance and the BIR set a lot of issues and conditions which did not allow this particular law to take effect. There are other BIR-related regulations such as the non-tax exemption of property transfers from one company to another company which is 100% owned. That's another deterrent to more projects. We hope that the BIR under the next administration will seriously reconsider that particular regulation if we want more activity in the real estate sector to flourish. So that's another legislation that's badly in need of a lot more focus. The other area to focus on would be more activity towards freeing idle government land. There are still plenty of government land all over the country which is idle, so this should be transformed into more productive uses. It would affect the real estate sector because a lot more of the land freed up could then be used for more productive purposes. Infrastructure development should be further accelerated. A lot more road systems should be created to reach the various areas of the country which are right now inaccessible. There should be more laws emphasizing countryside development, micro-enterprise development. This is one area where the present administration had some focus, but not sufficient enough to create a major impact. So the next administration should take a look at that more closely. More infrastructure projects will create a lot more activity all over. This will generate plenty more business opportunities and employment opportunities all over the countryside. The last issue, of course, is to take a look at how does the government enable more people to acquire their various homes, and serious review of the present lending policies of Pag-ibig. So these are the issues that beset the new president. It's not really that difficult. We just need a lot more rational thinking, a more comprehensive and cohesive action plan so that the entire economy would be benefited and the real estate sector will continue to contribute a significant role in the overall development efforts of the country.